Hi, my name is Michelle. The Iowa DNR has put together this video to help walk you through the Level 1 assessment and startup procedures as part of the Revised Total Coliform Rule. This rule was effective April 1st of 2016 and applies to all public water supplies in the United States, not just Iowa.
So we put together a startup procedures assessment form for the seasonal systems to put together. They need to fill out this and then turn it back in to our central office people. It's very simple. They write the name, public water supply ID number, when they open at the top. Go through the checklist. It will walk you through first your wells, their yes or no questions. If you do come up with a yes, there's a place to put the comments, like yes, I found a damaged well cap. There's a section for treatment. If you have treatment, you would fill out this section. If you don't, there's just a checkbox to say I don't have treatment, and then you move on. On the back side, it walks you through your storage. Most of the seasonal systems I run across in Iowa have hydropneumatic tanks, pressure tanks. So you're looking for things like if your hydropneumatic tank is in a pit, has there been any signs of flooding? Is there anything leaking? Is the pressure sensor broken? Just things that you would normally go through in the beginning of each season just to make sure your system is ready to go. You're not really doing anything different. You're just looking over your system before you open it to the public. Walk around your distribution system. Do you notice any leaks? Are there wet spots in the dirt or the soil that you haven't seen before? One thing that's not optional is to take a bacteria sample before you open to the public. There's a place on the form to fill out when you collected it and then what the result was. You can't open until you have a clean sample. So if you have to retake it, note that also. We require you to flush all of your service lines. We want to get anything that's been sitting there over winter or in the summer, depending on your season, flushed out of your system so you have fresh water flowing ready for the public to drink. One of the other things you should do before you open up is to go over your permit. The water supply operation permit has everything you need to know about your sampling. When's your bacteria sample? When's your season? When's your first nitrate due that year? So go through it and check off that you've reviewed it. And the last thing to do is fill out the certification area. You type your name, write your name, sign it, and then let us know when you did it, and then turn it back into their central office. Address is on the bottom. So to help you find and fix any potential problems, you have been sent a checklist to teach you how to perform a level one assessment. Each different type of system is going to be sent a different form. We have level one assessments that are geared towards groundwater systems with hydropneumatic storage, with elevated storage. We even have a checklist that's designed specifically for consecutive systems because they don't produce their own water. They're not going to have a section on wells. Each one of the types of forms has a place where you need to write your name, your public water supply ID number, and then circle whether you're community water supply or non-transient, non-community water supply, transient. And just like with everything else, if you don't know exactly where, how to fill it out, or what kind of water supply you are, give your friendly DNR person a call and we can help you through it. Each one of these forms is going to have kind of a general area where you ask questions. It asks questions like, has there been recent water outages? Was there a recent firefighting event? Was there a pipe break? Did you have a water main break? Did you have to do a boil advisory in the area? All these things are going to be will be walked through as part of this form. They're all yes or no questions. If you do answer yes, there's a place to describe what the reason was. Did you take corrective action to address that problem? Part of the assessment form can be done in your office, kitchen table, someplace comfortable. Part of it is where you go out and you actually look at your water supply. You look at the wells, you look at your treatment plant, water storage areas. Each one of these sections has a place where you can check yes or no that you've gone through it. At the end of it, don't forget to sign your name and then mail it back to your Des Moines person in the time that they've given you. And once again, if you have any questions, give us a call.